Raw, and I'm super excited because I have Sean Willingham in studio with me today. And Sean is a professional bull rider who's been with PBR for how many years now? You've been there a while.
19 years.
Oh my goodness. So they consider you like a PBR veteran, right?
Yes, most definitely a veteran. I've been around for a long time, a lot longer than majority of the guys that are on tour. I think I'm the only one left standing at my age group.
How's it kind of feel to like earn that status and have been in it for so long?
It blows my mind daily to realize I'm still able to compete at that level with all these young guys and still be competitive and stick with them.
Well, we're super excited to have PBR back at the Golden One Center January 25th through 27th. Are you going to be out at Golden One Center with us?
If I don't retire, I will be there. I have announced I was originally going to retire after this season.
Yeah.
And then I've kind of reevaluated my decision, and I was going to do it in New York City at the Madison Square Garden in January. So we'll see. I talked to my agent today, and we're still kind of talking about it and kicking it around. So hopefully you will definitely still see me here again in January.
Well, we sure hope so. I mean, I did see the news that you were going to retire after 2018 season, so I know how that calendar worked, but you think you might have to stick around a little longer, huh?
I do. I mean, I feel good today. I feel like I should be able to compete at this level for another year and be consistent and competitive at it. So we'll just see how I feel when the season's over and where we finish that in the
totally.
World standings to keep going.
Yeah, I gotta do what's best for you, because you've qualified for 11 world finals, so I mean, I know you've competed a lot over the years. What's been like the highlight? What's been one key highlight of your life? That was one of the best moments of my entire career.
I guess riding in the streets of New York City would be pretty big highlight. I have a picture of me on a bull, and the Empire State Building is in the background. We did a promotion deal the first year we ever went to ride bulls in Madison Square Garden. We set up arena right outside on the street, so everybody walking to tent and going to work that morning seen us. Here we are, but you know, some bull riders. We bucked 5 bulls in about 30 minutes, and it was 3 degrees outside, so it was very cold, but very very intense and kind of different. I've never ridden bulls when that cold of weather outside was the main thing. But it was pretty cool because, you know, New Yorkers had no clue what we was doing, and you know, we just set up the whole arena and bucked bulls on the street.
That is wild. So it was like a pop-up bull riding event.
Yes, exactly.
That's crazy. I can't believe the city of New York was like, yeah, pass, do that. That sounds awesome.
It's like a flash mob, but with real bull riding.
That's crazy. Do you remember what it was like to qualify for like your very first world finals ever?
I do. I was very excited. I was a young kid, and you know, that was always my dream, to make it to the world finals in Las Vegas. And I did it pretty at a young age. You know, it come pretty fast for me. Now looking back at it, you know, I've been there 11 times. This year we'll make 12. So yeah, I don't know which one's going to be sweeter, the first one or the last one.
How old were you when you made the first one?
20 years old.
Dang,
I guess.
That's wild. It's been such a good chunk of your life.
It's been a long time.
What's something, obviously it's challenging to just, I mean, stay on that animal when you're riding, but what's like a challenging part of being a bull rider that maybe the audience wouldn't realize, or something that they wouldn't expect that, you know, is something they don't see behind the scenes?
The traveling?
Being away from the family?
Yeah, I mean, that's the hard part for us, I believe, is traveling, because we don't really know where we're going to be at. We just know we're going to be very busy and go from here to there. And some days you're only home for a day or two. Sometimes you're gone for, you know, 2 or 3 weeks straight without going home. So the traveling adds up. Just depends on where you're at. You know, time changes and all that stuff on flying. And, you know, that's the hardest part of bull riding for me, I do believe, now that I'm older. When I was younger, I really didn't care. I enjoyed traveling, which I still enjoy it a lot, but it kind of takes a toll on you.
Oh, that totally makes sense. And being away from the family and all that absolutely makes sense. Well, thank you for traveling to Sacramento today. I think you're going to be hanging out with us at the Jason Aldean show tonight at Toyota Amphitheater, I heard.
Yes, we'll be there hanging out with Jason Aldean. I can't wait. I've never met him before. I'm looking forward to it tonight, and it's going to be exciting. The PBR, we have made him a belt buckle with a PBR on it, so we're gonna
get to give that
hopefully
to him
present that to him tonight as well while we're out there.
Dude, that's gonna be so cool. And you're gonna be hanging out at the Bull Tent before the Jason Aldean show kind of gets going. As soon as gates open, swing by the Bull Tent if you want to meet Sean. He's gonna be out there starting at 6 o'clock. As soon as gates open, you down to take some pictures with our listeners?
Oh, always. We'll take pictures and smile and do whatever we gotta
do. It's gonna be awesome. We even have, did you know we have a bull mascot?
Really?
We have Baxter the Backstage Bull. And I think we got to get Baxter and you in a photo. I mean, you with the bull,
sure.
Right?
I mean, just a lot of people are probably going to want a picture with the bull other than me, but we'll hope not. Maybe they'll come for me as well.
We can get everyone in the photo. Tonight at the Jason Aldean Show, Toyota Amphitheater, and hopefully we see you at PBR at Golden One Center, January 25th through 27th. It's going to be awesome. Thank you for coming in today,
Sean. Thanks for having me.